So at this level, from E we are having two options, C and D. If I choose C, from C it will directly go to A because C is already visited. Look at the diagram here. C is already visited, so we should not use this path. So this will become dead end. If I choose D, so from D we will reach A, but D is already visited here. Look at the diagram here. We should not use twice a vertex. So you have to use only starting vertex twice, where at first level starting point will be A and at last level starting point should be A. Like say previous solution I have highlighted here. So starting point is A and ending point is A. So this will also fails. Now we have to backtrack from here, this location to C, because for C we are having two options. So first for B we got only dead end, which is not a proper solution. Now we need to choose another method, like another vertex E. From C we have to visit E. From C we have to visit E. From E we can visit F, and from F we can visit B. So from B we can visit A. So if I choose this path, there is no repetitions other than source vertex. So this will be the another optimal solution. Likewise, we need to identify the solution where we can avoid the repetitions. So now from C we have to backtrack to D, where for D there are two options. Only for left hand side we have identified the second optimal solution. Now backtrack to D. Now from D we need to go for identifying another solution. So from D we can visit E. For D we are having two options. For C already we have identified the solution. From D we are visiting E now. From E we are going to F. From F we are choosing B, because for F we are having only one adjacent vertex because E is already visited. Now from F we are going to B. From B we are going to C, because for B there are two options. We can either choose A or C. If I choose A, it will be a dead end where C will be unvisited. So we need to choose the second choice, B to C and C to A. If I go through this path, I'll get the another optimal solution. Likewise, for the second children, C will be having lot of optimal solutions. So we need to construct separately state space for this node. So in order to generate the optimal solutions, we are having two separate algorithm. First one is for identifying the dead end, and second one is for identifying the next vertex, which means for identifying the next traversing vertex, we are maintaining the separate algorithm. First one is the input will be adjacent matrix. If I have five nodes or five vertex in a graph, it will be like 5 × 5 matrix. If I have a direct connectivity, I will have value as 1. If not, the value can be 0. The directed, it can be either a directed graph or undirected graph, but it should be a connected graph. So for understanding, we are having a lot of highlighted points. It is very useful for implementation also. Thank you. Third example for backtracking is subset sum problem. It is another important example for backtracking. So where we are having some set of numbers which is taken as S, and we'll be having a total which is taken as D. So the numbers can be either in ascending order. Since we are having algorithm, the numbers can be like S1 will be less than S2, and S2 will be less than S3 up to Xn, and all the numbers taken should be a positive number. where we need to check whether the D, the total is, the total is existed in the given subset or not, which means by adding some 3, 2 or 4 numbers, we need to match the total, and we have to provide all the possible solutions by using backtracking method. So in order to solve this problem, we are going to use state space tree by having two conditions like with and without, including numbers. So starting from the root, let us take this example. The numbers are s equal to 1, 3, 4 and 5 and d equal to 8, which means we are going to check the sum value as 8, which is taken as d. Now, from root, we are having two options. First number is, first taken value is 1, so with 1 and without 1. If with 1 means we can add 1 with the root value 0. So my updated value for this left hand side children is 1. First we will complete left hand side layer, first left hand side subtree, and then we will go for right hand side subtree. So with 1 means x taken value is 1. Now from this level we are taking second number 3. So with 3 and without 3. So with 3 means here I'm adding 3 with the root node. The root value is 1, so 1 plus 3 is 4. So updated value is 4. So the next value is 4. So with 4 and without 4. So if I have with 4 means 4 will be added with the root value. 4 plus 4 is 8. Now I got the solution where our total value is, since our total value is 8, so I got my first solution as this level. So we can simply highlight this solution. And then now we have to go back or backtrack to the next right children from by reaching the root node. So while backtracking from this level, we'll move to this portion root 4, and there is a condition like without 4. If without 4 means we should not add any value, like without 4 means we have to maintain the same value as root value. So the value is 4. If I try to add next to number 5, so 4 plus 5 is 9, 9 is greater than 8, so we can simply neglect this solution. So now from this level we have to backtrack to the previous node, which is root level 1. So at this level we are having without 3 condition. So without 3 means the same value will be taken as a children node. Now for this children 1, so the left hand side value is, since we are having at level number 3, we can take value as 4. So with 4 and without 4. So with 4 means 1 plus 4 is 5. So 1 plus 4 is 5. So updated value of left hand side children is 5. If I try to insert next value of 5, next value of 5 here with 5 means 4 plus 5, if, I mean 5 plus 5 is 10. 10 is greater than 8. So this will also fail. So now backtrack to this level. So I'm backtracking to this level. From here I'm having a condition like without 4. So without 4 means I have to maintain the same value for the children also, 1. So for 1 I'm having two conditions. I have to include the number 4. So with 5 and without 5. So with 5 means with root node I have to add number 5. So 1 plus 5 is 6. I made a mistake here. 1 plus 5 is 6. So 6, that it is not a solution, so simply we can neglect. Now from this level 1 plus, so since we are having condition like without 5, directly we can include 1 here for right hand children. So there is no solution here at this level. Now from this location, from level 1 we can backtrack to root level. So similarly from root node we can traverse to right side children without one condition. So whatever the conditions we have taken here, we can apply in right hand side also, like with 3, without 3 and with 4, without 4. We have to apply at all the levels and we need to identify the solutions. So in this example we are having two solutions. They are like solution 1 is 1, 3 and 4. You can look at the diagram 1, 3 and 4. And second solution is, look at this diagram, without 1, so without 1 means we should not include 1. Now with 3 and with 3 and with 5, so with 3 without 4, so that the layer be like without 1, with 3, without 4, with 5. So we have to neglect without numbers and we need to add one layer with numbers. Now 3 and 5 will be taken into account, so the value is, the solutions are 3, 5. So we are having an algorithm for better understanding. So in order to implement this method, we can apply this algorithm by having empty set, and also we can simply identify the next element for adding in the empty set. You can follow this one. So if you want to identify the solution, or if you want to understand in better way, you can try this example. And the numbers are S equal to 5, 10, 12, 13, 15 and 18, and D equal to 30, which is nothing but sum value. So kindly use state space tree for better understanding. Thank you.